Okay, so here's our second trap, you guys.
We got it!
I think we got one.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, we got a live. It's a nice big one.
Ah!
Okay.
Yeah.
We got to give it a humane death. Okay, it's dead. And we have two. Hey, wait, no, we're going
to
eat
back
that.
Channel. Today, we're going to do a gopher challenge. I brought five traps out here. We're going to set all five. We're going to try to catch gophers before dinner. We're going to cook and clean them and eat them. That's our goal. Right? Yeah. And we're going to use marinade on one, and we're going to do a buffalo dry rub on the other. So we got to go for here. We don't have very many on our property, so we're going to have to drive all over.
Yeah.
This one here is a female. You can tell because it's springtime, and she's coming out, and she's kind of peeing on the ground.
Ooh, this is a big one, you guys. This could feed two of us.
I'm not sure if any of us are quite excited, but we can try it.
We're not four.
If we were starving to death, this would be really good.
But two goats.
Wait, you're not going to try it, Wyatt?
You going to try a little nibble?
Okay, so see, no. That thing turns. Looks like I can feel another runway coming back. So we got to be real careful. You want about, I don't know, at least 12 inches of straight runway, or you pretty much never get them in a trap. All right.
And okay. One, we're gonna go.
And I always like to use a stick, and that way you don't touch this part of the stick so the gopher can't smell you. You know, just like any animal, it kind of smell. And you clean out all the big dirt clods. There's a nice one. Ooh, you guys, this is gonna be a killer. And see how I scrape the wall? I'm trying to feel if there's another runway. See, I can feel it right back there. So, this part is the part that's going down the trap, and right there is where I felt that other runway. So see, you can tell we have plenty of room. That next runway on the left starts right there. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And right. The flag.
And Wyatt got the flag up. And I've never eaten a gopher, and I've never gutted one. So this will be an experience for all of us.
All right, let's try it out.
Michael's really excited.
Oh, that trap just sprung.
And we'll have to do it again.
We'll have to do it again.
And the gopher's like, what?
You know, something about these traps, you guys, I've learned. If you set them like this, they tend to get hung up. If you go down or you pull them way too far forward, they tend to not go off. Right in the middle. Like that. And this one, right there. That's generally how I do it. And sometimes you'll come out and these traps will fail. They won't even close. And you're like, what did I do wrong? Scrape that out.
Do that?
Yeah.
And
so, yeah, so here, I'm going to do something to show you. So right here, you guys, you see down in here? See, this is the hammer. This is what's going to close on that gopher. See how it's going to come up? It looks like it's going to hit right here. That's going to allow that trap not to fully close. And that gopher will actually be able to wiggle out of that. So we're gonna see this edge on this trap. We're gonna dig this out because you want that trap to do a complete close, because if you don't, that gopher will get out. It's amazing what they can get out of.
Yeah, I was like, is that a gopher?
Okay,
trap?
There you go. So I didn't set it just right on the tip. I set it kind of back a little bit because that gopher's gonna come up. He's gonna see that and he's gonna throw a little bit of dirt on it. So you don't want the trap just to spring on the dirt. You want the gopher to be like, ah, man, there's something in my hole. I threw some dirt on it, didn't move. I'm gonna go ahead and push it out with my nose. He comes up, dead. How'd that sound?
He did.
All right, let's go.
I'm not that even.
Okay, so we set our traps. We went back 2.5 hours later. You can see this one has sprung. And we'll go ahead and, oh, you guys, we're gonna have gopher. All right, now who wouldn't eat this yummy meal?
No one.
Mm.
I'll touch it.
Yeah. And this is called a pocket gopher because when it eats, it tucks its grasp in there. See how far my finger goes? And it fills its little pockets full of grass and then goes back down the hole. Dinner. What's for dinner? You're going to tell your family, gopher. Okay, so here's our second trap, you guys.
We got it!
I think we got one.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, we got a live. It's a nice big one.
Ah!
Okay.
Yeah.
We got to give it a humane death. Okay, it's dead. And we have two. Hey, wait, no, we're going to eat that. Don't crush it.
Yeah.
See, now look, you can see where grass is being tucked in there. Same thing. Look at that. Ooh, those, ooh.
Daddy.
Sorry.
He's a big one.
He is a big one. Oh, we got both of them.
Daddy.
Woohoo.
Dad, we got both of them.
Yeah.
Daddy, this one was... I saw it move.
Yeah, so what's really cool, you guys, is we have a neighbor. Our hay field's right there. We gassed most of ours, and we can only set two traps on our entire 50 acres of field. And so we were able to come over to the neighbors, and we got two gophers. So we're going to go try them tonight.
Dad, look at the tail.
All right, Wyatt, you pack this thing. This will be good. Got
Daddy,
it?
I think I saw that baby gopher.
Yeah, look at Mama.
Man, that was heavy.
It's heavy. Wow. Look at Mom.
Show me. Wow, dude.
He's heavy.
He's heavy? It's a big one.
You want this fish super heavy.
Well, no, not really.
All right, you packed it to the further, bud.
Dad, you can hear this.
Two huge gophers, and we're about ready to clean them on our cleaning table, and then we're going to barbecue them.
With my barbecue sauce.
All right, I think this is going on our YouTube video. All right, so my parents, they were like, you're going to eat a pocket gopher. We're coming up to watch this. So we're going to do a barbecue, and we're going to do a dry rub.
And I got to do my barbecue sauce here, and my dry feet.
Okay.
All right, we're rolling.
Yeah.
You know what? I actually have never done this before. So I'm going to skin them. I'm going to skin them first. They look kind of like a squirrel.
Yeah.
Gross.
But they're a baby.
Oh, you guys, I think there's some really good meat on here.
Ugh.
I think this is a boy. See the testicles?
Ugh.
I think it's a boy. And you can see where the scissor trap, you know, went around his legs and around his chest and kind of basically crushed him.
Ugh.
Arr.
He's dead yet.
Yeah. So we definitely want to eat his legs because there looks like some yummy meat on that. I don't know if I can eat it with like a little.
No, I'll take the little paw.
Take the little claw. Okay, we're gonna cut that off. Yeah, that looks a little gross. Here, Max. Feed your scraps to the dogs because when I was up here by myself, there were so many gophers in this field when I first moved up here. I fed gophers to my dogs like 4 a day, and I had 4 bloodhounds. I think I'm just going to cut his tail off. You'll see his tail sticking through the... It'd be kind of cool to pelt that.
Huh.
You want to see his pockets? I think I showed you on that. But that's where they store... There's some grass. That's where they store all their grass. And then they take them way down in their hole and bury it. I mean, it's finger deep.
Huh.
Now we're up around his throat. There's his bottom teeth. I can feel his jaw right there. So if you guys ever watched that movie, Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? You know, that guy's like a gopher and they're eating them. So we were like, you know what? Man, that's something else. All right, so we finally got the skin off, you guys. It's actually really hard to get off around their neck and their face. So this is what they look like left. So we've skinned it.
Ugh.
And the dogs love it. Willow, who wants this, Max? So you can watch the dogs eat it. I mean, that's like delicious for them. So now I'm going to go ahead and gut this thing. It must have been like pee or something. Man, they got a ton of guts. Gross.
Sick. If only I could see my face on the other side of the camera.
Sorry, love. Here, Willow, it's your turn.
Gross.
Yeah, I think this is boy.
It's my gopher.
There it is, you guys. So you can see all the meat. Here, I'll rinse this off so it looks better.
I shouldn't have eaten anything all day, so I'd be super hungry.
The dog's like, oh, give that to me. All right.
Daddy.
Yes, sir. Look at all that yummy meat. And we're going to barbecue this up.
Yeah, and all right. Johnny
Season. Yeah, we're going to use Johnny Season.
You all right, want that's more, Zangy? You
like the guts? Should I do the incision here and say...
Gross, man.
This is where the guts
you
are.
Want more? Zangy, over here. Oh, gross.
Yeah.
These you guys with those scissor traps. And you can see this is the bloodshot meat. This is where it came in. And it actually broke ribs on these gophers.
That's from those cinches grabbing a hold of it and choking it.
Huh.
I just thought that was interesting because look inside. You see how the ribs are broke?
Huh.
And that wasn't for me. That was from those traps. So anyways, that's kind of interesting. I've never done this. Yeah, there you go. Okay, let's take our meals in. Get a fire going.
All right.
All right, guys. So here's our fire pit. We've had this for over a year. It's awesome. You can get this going, get it nice and hot. We're going to cook our gophers on this. And you can swing it off, you know, if it gets too hot. And it's really been holding up. And we bought this at Coastal Farm and Ranch. And I think we got it on sale for, was it $150, $200? Mm-hmm. It was actually pretty cheap. And we really like it. And this gives you that nice woods, you know, smoke on your meat. And it's going to make those gophers taste amazing.
Johnny, it's pretty good and they cook chicken.
Ooh, all right. Johnny seasoning's good on chicken?
So I had a hard time getting the fur off the teeth and stuff, but we're not going to eat the head anyway, so we're just going to go like that. So why you go ahead and put seasoning on yours. We're going to put Johnny's seasoning on one. Put it all the way down. Yeah, keep putting it. Here, I'll put it over closer to you. There. Season that whole bird. That gopher. Shake it. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it. Go like this. Go like this. Like that. There you go. Okay, let's flip it.
Ooh.
Okay, put it all down the back of it. Make sure you get around its neck. I think that'd be good meat. Okay, that's good. Kind of rub that into that meat. Throw him back on the grill. And then we're gonna put barbecue sauce on this one. So, and I think I'll golden him first and then I'll put the sauce on. All right. Looks weird with their teeth, don't it?
Ugh.
You can see how they're really cooking up nice, you guys. I think they're gonna taste really good. Their faces, with the teeth, that's kind of creepy.
Well, it's appetizing.
Yeah. Anyways, yeah, yum. All right, you guys, so Beautiful's inside. She is cooking us some mac and cheese for the kids, just in case they don't like gopher. And we got a coleslaw. And I don't know why they reared up like that when they cooked. It's kind of weird. But I have a feeling they're going to be super good. Mm. There we go, you guys. I got barbecue sauce on that one. I'm using the Baby Ray. And I'm just going to basically smother it to try to hide the taste and smell of gopher. All right, so you guys, we got our gophers ready. This is our barbecue sauce. I kind of probably overcooked them, but just because I was kind of nervous about eating one. And this is our dry rub. And I left the tail on that because some people said you could hold it like a cob of corn, you know, grab its teeth, grab its tail. And then I guess. It's not bad. It's chewy. Huh. It's chewy.
I don't know if I like the face you're making here.
I like the idea of holding it with the tail and the teeth. That's a great way of doing it. And you can eat it like that.
Maybe you're gonna, you know, chop some little piece off for me.
Okay.
It's highly unappetizing looking.
What's it smell like?
It stinks. Actually, when I actually tasted it, I was like, I almost threw up, actually. But I want to be honest. I want to be honest with you. That's the face
Daddy,
I got.
The door comes with my mole traps, and then I can't get them up. Daddy.
Okay, hold on. I got to try this barbecue so we can end this. My first impression is I'd have to be really hungry. Yeah, Naked and Afraid. My mom loves that show. The barbecue is better. It hides that meat. All right, you want to try a bite? I definitely missed the tail. I like the other one. This one's definitely easier to eat, and it's not so messy. I kind of like that. This one, I wish I would have left the tail on, because, see, I'm getting barbecue sauce on me. Oh.
Daddy.
All right, somebody else's turn. All
right, so I tried both gophers. Now it's Beautiful's turn. Which one do you want to try first, the barbecue or the dry rub?
I don't know. I don't think I can pick up that whole thing. That looks really gross.
I think it's a good way.
A little bit of
muscle.
Yeah.
You could try the front shoulder.
Is that somehow better than the back leg?
Well, I mean, the back, we'll see what the barbecue one wasn't bad. Why, you want to try a bite, bud? You know what? I think next time I'll probably cut the head off. I think that kind of distorts what it looks like.
Here. I just need a knife. That's what I need
here. Oh, I got my pocket knife that I cut it up, cut it with.
No. You didn't even wash it.
Okay, here we go.
Here, let's get a little.
Okay, now I want honest. Okay, what do you think?
It's super chewy and tough.
Is there any flavor to it that you don't like?
It's kind of weird. I don't know.
Huh.
It's different.
If you were starving, would you eat it?
Yeah.
Yeah, see?
Yeah, naked.
Yeah, I'm naked, like, and afraid.
It's a good thing I have some coleslaw.
Hey, if you guys want someone to go on naked and afraid, there she is. She wants to go on naked and afraid. Okay, try the dry rub and see what you think. I don't think you're having much fun with this.
No.
Oh, yeah, I dig
out. It's highly unappetizing.
Here, try that side, because it's brand new.
Well, I don't know if that helps. It looks, it's burnt.
Just pick it up, like I did it with the tail.
I know, it was gross.
Yeah, try it, Mom. Here, jump over on the side, so we'll get you, I want your honest opinion. So go in front. Well, this is like a family affair. Okay, Tawny has a dry piece of rub. Yeah, I thought that was strong. I could taste it. Oh, yeah, Mom's going for it.
I don't know. It's all the same.
So.
I'd have to be really hungry.
Yeah.
Really naked and afraid.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you don't like it? It has like a.
Well, the problem is, you know, it's a rodent.
Yeah.
You know, and that, it just kind of like puts a dark cloud over it.
Yeah, and then you can see its whole little legs.
I mean, and you know, is that appetizing to look at?
No, it's not actually. I wish I would have chopped that. Yeah, try it.
Yeah, I think it'd be better if it was like cut up in like. You know,
see, my mom's
like
a carnivore.
Like a little chicken leg or something, you know.
I'd have to be all naked and afraid for weeks before.
Oh, Mom, spit it out even.
Get away from me. You'll never kiss me again.
Wait, you spit yours out too?
Well, I chewed on it for a while. It was tough.
All right.
That's tough.
All right. Okay, so the recap of eating our delicious gopher. Here, let me get the little face up there so you can see it. I didn't really care for it.
No, I didn't care for it either.
The barbecue one was a little better because I think the barbecue sauce hit it, the flavor. The dry rub, this guy, the smell, when I bit into the back leg, the smell of it was atrocious. And I was like, I don't think I like it. So, hey, you guys, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. I wouldn't recommend going out catching a gopher, skinning it, gutting it, and eating it.
It's probably edible, but you probably want to be starving first.
Yeah. Tawny's mom and dad are going to love that video. Yeah. All right, thanks for watching, guys.
Thanks for watching.
All right, you guys, just keep the gophers for the dogs. They're not worth anything.
I don't think they've ever had a cooked one before.
Willow, come here. Get your gopher. Oh, we'll give it to the puppy. Here he comes.
There he comes.
Okay, let's see what he... Sunny. All right, here he goes. Okay, you get the dry rub.
All right. Dry rub. Feast away, little puppy. Grow big and strong.
Oh, yeah. Max loves his. He got the barbecue. How is that? Is it good? Oh, tail's a wagon. That's a sign of improvement.